Welcome to Keyssentials, quick tips for animations on the web. In this video, I'll be covering how to do a SVG textpath animation on scroll. This tutorial was inspired by a great effect from a New York Times article where the text slides into view as you scroll. Pretty cool. To make a similar effect, we'll start by creating a path in Affinity Designer or Illustrator, whatever you're most comfortable in. And just draw a nice curved path and then export that as SVG. We'll quickly run that path through SVG OMG to reduce a lot of the extra code that the graphical editor puts in there. Then we'll move over into our code where we have a simple article already set up with a few paragraphs and styles. We'll insert our SVG where we want the effect to appear. We can also clear out a few of these extra attributes that SVG OMG did not take out, but are not necessary. To add text into our graphic, we wrap it with a text element directly in the SVG. For this text to follow along our path, we first need to add an ID, let's say text curve, and then we'll wrap our text down below in a text path with an href pointing to that ID of text curve. This text path produces a great effect all on its own because it's plain text in an SVG that is still accessible. It can be screen read or copied and pasted out, which is really quite great. We can use textpath's start offset attribute to change where the text is on our path. In a moment, this is the value we'll animate with JavaScript to get the sliding effect. Let's go ahead and give our textpath an ID of textpath and our SVG an ID of textcontainer. Then in our JavaScript, we'll use document.query selector, target our textpath, and store it in a variable. To animate the text along the path, first we'll write a function to update the offset of our text. Next, we'll write an onScroll function to control our animation that will get called whenever the window is scrolled with addEventListener. Performance can be an issue because this function will get called a lot when the user is actively scrolling, so let's wrap our update code in requestAnimationFrame. This helps ensure we're only updating the page when the browser is rendering a new frame, which should prevent our animation from being jerky. Right now, we can call our updateTextOffset function using the window.scrollY value to see that everything's working. However, this isn't the same effect we're going for, so let's get into some math to get our text moving in the right direction. We want to track the SVG's position to know exactly where it is in the viewport, so let's use query selector for the text container. Inside of our scroll function, we'll call getBoundingClientRect to get an object containing the elements width, height, and xy coordinates in the viewport. Dividing the y coordinate by the window height will give us a percentage-like representation of where the element is in the viewport, with 1 being the bottom and 0 being the top. Now, we want to combine this percentage with the length of the path. To get the path that's being used, we can use query selector plus getAttributeHref to make sure we're getting the right path. Then, with getTotalLength, we can get the length of the path, multiply the scroll percent times the path length, and presto! We have our text moving with the scroll. We may want to additionally multiply that by 2 to increase the effect. Make sure that our text is off screen and animates a little faster as we scroll. We'll also want to call updateTextPathOffset with the path length on first run so that the text starts from off screen before any scrolling. If we want to hide our path that the text is actually moving along, we can simply remove the stroke and our text will move along our invisible path. There you have it, a scroll-based SVG textpath animation. Links to the final code, live demo, and other resources are available below. If you've enjoyed this episode, be sure to hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to the Keyframers channel if you'd like to see more. You can also support us by buying some developer merch from our store at keyframe.rs/merch or pledging at patreon.com/keyframers. Thanks for watching. Adios, amigos.